time to put the mount back in Mount Ocean.
Jackson, welcome to Africa, welcome to Tanzania.
If you want to go learn about the Serengeti, go watch a documentary on it.
Because we can't teach you anything.
All I can say is that this has exceeded my expectations.
Mind's blown every single day.
More so than I expected, obviously, because it exceeded my expectations.
We are at the entrance of the MountOcean National Park, and over here there's this big fake elephant. So I was like, oh, let's go check out the elephant. And then, real live giraffes. One, two, three, four here.
This place has all of the charismatic megafauna that I've read about and learned and studied about my entire life. And they're all just so close in proximity that we've seen many of them within hours of each other. All the big cats, from cheetahs to leopards to lions, it's just incredible. The wildebeest, the hippopotamuses, giraffes.
The elephants. We were surrounded by 40 elephants the other day.
Yeah, the elephants were incredible. So just within a fairly short amount of time, we've just been able to see all of the big animals that you've read about and learned about your whole life.
We're surrounded. Millions of wildebeest today. They're all making their migration, which they're migrating all year. They go from south to north.
Yeah, it's been incredible. I just can't believe the density of animals. They are just so thick. We've been driving for days and days, and we're never without sight of many, many animals. It's just incredible.
That's the cheetah. He's on the top of the termites mound.
I know what's that.
So that was funny.
I'm just gonna close. Now look at that one.
It was just amazing to see these large cats and be in such close proximity to them. That one right there is the lead lioness, or the matriarch of this pride, and so she's been tagged with a radio collar. And they'd also had a kill recently, so that morning they had just a major feed, and so they're covered in flies because they had totally just had a bunch of blood all over them. And then later, of course, we're cruising along and a bunch of little cubs came out, some little lion cubs, which is beautiful.
This is what we call the African massage.
We just finished day 4 of the safari. Mike and I were talking about all the lions that we saw today, and our voices totally scared off a bunch of zebras and water bucks. Like, we caught the tails of them. So this is where we're staying tonight. Well, actually, this is our second night. Come inside. We're staying. We are glamping. This is not tenting. This is glamorous camping.
Pure glamping. There's the bed.
Bathroom.
This is pretty crazy.
So it's 7:30, which means it's dinner time. We're just sitting here waiting to be escorted up to the main tent. And as we're sitting here, we can hear lions. They're making this low grunting sound, which turns out is a mating call. So the rule here at the camp is that guests cannot walk by themselves after dark. So we have a flashlight, we just shine it out on the main path. They can see it from the main lodge, and someone will come down, pick us up to walk us back, just in case there's a wild animal encounter. Every day we spend hours driving in the safari jeep, but we're never bored. The whole time we are engaged, either standing up out of the top or looking out the windows, just looking for that next animal. And we've been so surprised at how easy it is to find these other animals, whether there's some zebras off in the distance or a pumba munching grass along the road. And it's gotten to the point where we've caught ourselves saying, like, you'll be looking out and see an animal, but it's, oh, it's just another giraffe. We've seen lots of those. Like, who says that? So every day when we're reflecting on the day, every night, we're just counting ourselves so lucky. Like, this is the experience we're having, and we are seeing every animal that's been on our Africa bucket list. So we're so happy.
Join us next time on MountOcean as we visit a traditional Maasai village and we travel into the Ngorongoro crater looking for the critically endangered black rhinoceros.